The tip of the sword that pierced his side was sharp enough to ensure he died. As sharp as my sin, though good I'd tried, but failed, for which he was crucified. The shaft of the sword that pierced his skin was strong enough to plunge deep within, as long as my longing to be free from sin, not to be, unless he would die to win. The iron of the sword that pierced his flesh was hard enough to part like mere mesh, as cold as my callousness, rushing in to kill, then die for him to revive afresh. The hand on the sword that drove it through belongs to a sinner, like me and you, we three whom he made reference to, saying, Father, forgive them, they know not what they do. The eye of the man that gripped the sword was blind, till the blood from the living word bled into it. Thus it was restored to life, but to see its lifeless lord. I think of that eye when I look at this bridge. How it couldn't see death being dead, but to live was touched by the last drops of life before death, only then born again to see but his last breath. In that eternal, momentous breath, could it see that the bridge there before it was straight as could be? And so easy to cross the dark waters below, having been blind, fallen in from now till years ago, and seeing the straight way across falters though. For beyond is a curve whose end I don't know, and the bridge looks quite sturdy, but beyond it my eye finds rocks and gravel and dirt, just like the path behind. I see lights that aren't lit there, on the far side. If I cross, will they magically light, thus to guide? Over there weeps a willow, beckoning to the brave. Does it weep pain for the fearful, or joy for the saved? My hands are now shaking, like that hand long ago, as it thrust forth its weapon, my sins in its tow. Will these hands grab the rails of the bridge, and then pull me across to a life through his death that is full? Will I pull as hard as he pushed the sword through, when the iron made a bridge from our sin-filled hand to the life at the other, sharp, deadly end? Life drawn closer with each inch of iron sinking in. Whether shaft made of iron or a bridge made of wood, representing the distance between evil and good, the tip of the sword, where the road has its end, is buried in Christ, but not seen round the bend. I approach this bridge, or a creek in a park. From beginnings of light to the comings of dark, one may picture this scene at a park named Sidecut, and approach a bridge made of wood there within, seeing the bridge made of iron, killing him and our sin.